My fiancé and I were wandering around up in the Pocono Mountains at night a few years back. It was pitch black out, the kind of dark you get during dead winter, and everything is really still and silent. I had a flashlight, and we were driving pretty slow through a wooded area near this abandoned resort. Penn Hills for anyone who wants to know about it. We're having a good night, and I'm just casually lighting the trees up, maybe expecting to see a few deer or something, when maybe 100 feet or so back, I saw this tall, skeleton-looking thing hanging off of a tree. I instantly started sobbing and shaking and screaming for my fiancé to speed up. When we were safe, he asked me what was up, and I told him about what I saw. This thing was almost glowing white, like when it snows in the middle of the night. It was about as tall as the tree it was hanging off of, but was so skinny that it didn't look large, if that makes sense. I tried to rationalize it off as a trick of the light. Maybe it was a reflector or something. I don't know. Either way, I'm almost convinced it was a skinwalker I saw, based on how my body reacted to it. We've been up there a couple of times after, and we've never actually been able to find the route we were on when I saw it. It's probably for the better, honestly. I just got home from a road trip, and I've been thinking about something I saw and can't make sense of. Maybe some of you have seen something like it. My wife and I were driving on Highway 97 South near Mount Shasta, California. It was about midnight, and we were driving through a heavily wooded area without any street lamps. We rounded a corner when I saw something fast and low to the ground dart across the street, about 50 or 60 yards ahead of us. I saw the glowing animal eyes and a body that was the size or shape of a big dog. We saw animals the whole road trip, and like usual, I asked my wife if she saw it, and she confirmed. The body wasn't 100% clear because our headlights hadn't reached the section of the road yet. When we got to the exact point in the road where the animal crossed, we looked to that side to see if there was anything there. There was a man dressed in army fatigues walking down the road. He didn't look at us, he just kept walking. It was pitch black, and he didn't have any type of light with him. He was only lit up by our headlights. We both got full body chills when we saw him, because we were definitely expecting to see an animal. I know that area has a magical, mystical history with a lot of unexplained sightings. This is unlike anything I've ever experienced before. We were totally creeped out. I still can't make heads or tails of this, so I figured I'd post it here. Has anyone else had something like this happen to them? This happened to my big brother when he was 15. We grew up on the Navajo Reservation in Arizona. He was coming home from hanging out with a friend, and it was probably around 2 a.m., although his curfew was 11. When he came in, my guardian started to yell at him, but stopped because she noticed my older brother was crying and talking in a hysterically frightened tone. Apparently, he came in the back gate and saw a coyote standing propped up on its hind legs against the back door, looking in the window. This wasn't so odd because it was Arizona, but when he came closer, the coyote turned its head to look at him, and as it did, it turned its whole body and started walking toward him on two legs like a man. My brother swears it looked too big to be a coyote. He ran out the back gate and came around to the front. To this day, he still cries talking about it. He is convinced he encountered a skinwalker watching our family. Some backstory. My boyfriend and I just bought our first house in June, on a lake about an hour northeast of Seattle, Washington. Aside from the lake community we're a part of, there really isn't a large population around here. We're in between a few larger towns, but they're all about a 20-minute drive from where we live. Our house is backed right up against the Cascade Mountains. We're pretty much the last bit of population before the mountains begin. About 30 yards from our driveway is a dead-end road that turns off the main lake road and goes back into the woods a few miles. There are a few gated Forest Service logging roads that branch from this road. My boyfriend and I ride our dirt bikes up these roads, and they themselves go on for miles. But there really aren't any other houses in this area, except for a few that are all on the main dead-end road. Before taking the dirt bikes up it, I had walked up this road a few times exploring the area, and it always felt a little odd to me. My boyfriend had said things like, "This road is creepy, even in broad daylight." It totally could have been that it was just very wooded in most spots and therefore shaded, and the lack of houses that made it odd, but I stopped walking up this road for this reason. When we moved in, I was dog-sitting my friend's pit bull, Bella. She was about 70 pounds and was a total fearless brat. She was kind of aggressive with other dogs, and even with some people. I would walk her up the dead-end road pretty often while I had her, because there were hardly any houses and no traffic. One day, we were about 2 miles up the road, and had come down a small hill onto a flat, treeless area, where there was an old abandoned barn and a large field that the road cut through. There was tall grass on either side of the road. When we got to the area, Bella's tail went down, and she kept her head really low. She also started to look around and back behind us, just acting nervous, which was odd for her. As we were coming around a turn, about 100 yards in front of us was a logging road that went off the road and straight up a hill. It had a large gate at the bottom to keep vehicles out. My boyfriend and I had put our dirt bikes under this gate before to go riding up the trails, so I know how tall it is. The top bar of the gate comes up to my chest, and I'm 5'5". What I saw still scares me to think about. Standing right in front of this gate was this huge black dog. It was standing broadside with its head low, and I'm almost positive it was looking toward us, because I couldn't make out a snout or ears. I couldn't see a tail either, but it may have been lower between its hind legs. The shoulder of this thing was higher than the top bar of the gate, because it was blocking part of it from view. I stopped instantly and held Bella's harness so she couldn't advance forward and catch sight of this thing, because aggressive dog problems. I looked at this thing for probably 2 seconds total before turning back and hauling ass back up the road, because I heard the thing growl. 100 yards away from it, and I heard this fucking thing growl, this awful, almost hissing sounding growl. I was totally fucking terrified, and at this point, so was Bella. It was a long 2 miles back, and I couldn't stop looking over my shoulder, and Bella was also freaked out the whole time. The growling, massive black dog wasn't the only thing I was so terrified of. I also had this awful, awful feeling of fear and dread come over me when I saw it. It was overwhelming, and I'd never felt anything like it. Even in typing this and remembering the details, it makes me feel jumpy. It took me a long time to feel okay and safe in our new house, especially at night. Even now, I have a really hard time if I'm home alone. My boyfriend is pretty sure I saw a black bear. I did not see a bear. I grew up in rural Pennsylvania and have seen more black bears than he probably seen in his entire life. This thing had long skinny legs and a deeply curved ribcage and belly similar to a Doberman. Wolves don't live in this area, and even if they did, this would have been an abnormally large skinny wolf. Now in reading through this sub, I've come across skinwalker encounters. I pretty much lost my shit when I read the similarities. I'm beginning to become more and more convinced that what I saw wasn't a normal, natural thing.